Welcome back, everybody. Let's continue 12.3 with arc length parameterizations for vectors. Let's just jump right into it with an example. We're going to find the arc length parameterization of the line RT equals 2 plus 3T for the X component, 2T for the Y component, and 5 minus T for the Z component. So in terms of, we want to do the integration. We want to use the integral formula for arc length. So, and we want to go for use T as something in the output. So we're going to use U as a dummy variable for now. I just replace R of U with, or R of T with R of U. And so that's what our vector looks like. We're going to integrate dr du. So the integral of dr du in general for a line, because this is just a line right here, is the magnitude of b. Isn't that neat? We take the derivative of this, and the derivative with respect to u here, r naught's a constant vector. U is the thing we're integrating or taking the derivative of. It just goes away. We're left with v. This is consistent for all straight lines. So an arc length parameterization is going to have 0 to t for arc length for a line. And when I go through it, normally we integrate that, we get u, because we're doing, remember, use the dummy variable. We got u times the magnitude of b from 0 to t, s equals t magnitude b. So for a straight line, t equals s over the magnitude of b is the substitution we're going to make. This is only for straight lines, not curves. Curves are going to be different. So, but the straight line is going to have that v as the derivative every time. So what we're doing, we find the magnitude of the vector there. We're taking 3, 2, right there, 3, 2, and oh, maybe I should use then. 3, 2, and -1. We're doing the magnitude of that. Bam, we get 14. So s equals t over times the square root of 14. T equals s over the square root of 14, just like we were saying over here, t is s over the magnitude of the vector. So r of s, we just change, we're subbing out t for s over root 14. This would otherwise be the same formula we have up here. Just t is now s over square root of 14. We, you know, pass it out, and there we go. Combined into one vector, done. So we did, if we look at a little different time steps, if we do s equals 0, we're stuck with, we have r naught still, t 205. If we do r1, we've got 2 plus 3 over square root of 14, then 2 over root 14, and then 5 minus 1 over root 14. The distance from s equals 0 to s equals 1 along the arc length is 1. Then we do s equals 3. It's a little hard to see because I didn't, especially with all these roots in there, but still, we're on a curve. Just take it for, take my word on it that the distance is 2 along these, because that's what we set it up on. We're integrating, we're using distance as our parameter. So s equals 0 to 3 would be an arc length of 3 along it. Notice the time steps. If we had s equals 0, 1, 2, and 3, like here, t is not getting very big. 3 over the square root of 14 is still less than 1. So we get all these steps in less than 1 second. If we compare that with arc length in chapter 10, we've got, we're just doing the arc length regularly. We know that the s equals 0 was t equals 0. And s equals 3 gives us t equals 3 over root 14. We integrate along that. We still have our dr dt. It's still the same. So we got root 14. We integrate it. We got t times root 14 evaluated from t equals 0 to t equals 3 root 14. You'll see we get 3 steps. So I guess you don't really need to take my word on it. You could always test it and show that the arc length is the value for it. Let's do another example together. We looked at this before, maybe not with the same coefficients, but cosine t, sine t, and t made a nice little circular helix that went up. That was a real pain in the butt to try to draw. We did it in 12.1 in class. So let's look at doing a parameter here for arc length. If I take the derivative, well, and we're going to restrict it to 0 to 2 pi, just one revolution. We do r prime of t. We have negative 8 sine t, 8 cosine t, and 6, which is not 0 for all t. So when we use u, we replace t with u. And I'm just squaring each of those things for our arc length formula. Negative 8 sine u squared is 64 sine squared u. 8 cosine u squared is 64 cosine squared u. And we can factor out the 64, and then the 6 squared is 36. Using our trig identities, sine squared u plus cosine squared u equals 1. We're left with roots of 64 plus 36, which is the square root of 100, which is 10. So s equals 0 to t of 10 du. We integrate, we have 10 u, we're evaluating from u equals 0 to u equals t. So s equals 10 t, or t equals s over 10. We can apply these up in here. T equals s over 10, replace it up there to find these steps in s, which I will do in a little bit. But r of s is listed now rather than r of t. And we've just replaced t with s over 10. Everything looks the same. So we, in starting at t equals 0, we had started at 0, 0. We want to sync up our orientation. Like I was saying, we want to replace our limits of integration with the one, well, not the limits of integration. This is just the route that the line segment. We want to replace the curve segment. Curve segment sounds good. T goes up, t is being turned into s equals 10t. So t equals s over 10. If I plug that in here, I've got 0 is less than s over 10, which is less than 2 pi. That's just replacing t with s over 10. Multiply through by 10 on both sides, and we get 0 is less than s, which is less than 20 pi. So that's how you do that. You're just doing the replacement that we had, t equals s over 10. And solving for s. So this is now doing s rather than t. Now we're doing little distance steps along this route, spiraling up along this helix that we've created. And if it was a butterfly, like fluttering up along this little loop, we could find its position. That's because that's what r is. R is a position vector. It points to a location. We could find its position at any given, after any given time with the r of t, or after any given distance that the butterfly has flown using r of s. So let's say it flew 60 units. We just plug in 60, and we can see it started at 800, and now it's at 7.68, negative 2.24, and it's at 36 in the air. That'll be it for this section. Peace.